Yo, what's up? So it's been a hot minute, and by that I mean, I guess, yesterday was the last stream, but today we are going to play around with our test device. So our test device is a satellite communication device. Give me a second. So this is the SpaceBeaver device. So this was an early prototype. Little big, but you know. And this is our current prototype. Ooh, much smaller. Let's hold them up side by side. So we're gonna make sure that our new test device works for a flexible-ish value of works. Now, this itself cannot talk to the satellite. We need to use our friendly satellite modem. I'm not going to show the front of it because it's got some stuff on it. It's the friendly satellite modem. This is the antenna for the thing. This is our test device. We are going to see how it goes. Now, the chances of success are at least, I would say, moderately high, because we had an earlier version that worked of this device. It was just manufactured differently. And so this is essentially like a attempt at making the device in a way that we could like make a bunch of them, because that's important. And of course, you know, you never know if when you go to like scale up from making two to being able to make more than two, it's going to work. So good first sign. We got a green LED lit up on the device. We're going to go ahead and switch to terminal, and we're going to... Oh, hey! I don't know of, like, great, easy resources for those things. Probably, I mean, like, that's a lot to learn, right? So, like, I think learning all those things is going to be hard. Okay. Okay, cool. So we have a new USB device that just showed up. Although we have a bunch of new USB devices that just showed up, so this might not be the device. In fact, it doesn't look like this is the device. Okay. Okay, well, we've got something in TTY-ACM0. That's not the one that I want. I want the firmware. Called device-FW. Okay. Interesting. This claims to be up to date. We'll find out. Denny Lee has a fantastic book on Introduction to PySpark. Okay, cool. Virtual env is not... That's funky. Let's I guess Anaconda virtual. Let's go ahead. Yeah, we'll do that, I guess, and then we'll do this. So we're gonna install virtual env. It's like a funky mix of Conda and VM. Not a great practice, but it is what we're gonna do. Another one is to make. Oh, and I don't have a ground plane set up for this thing right now, so it's probably not gonna like connect. But we can at the very least see if like it's able to talk to the modem and stuff. We wouldn't necessarily expect it to work. Huh. That. Is fun. So let's uninstall that and then let's pip install virtual env. We could also do a conda deactivate. Virtual end parts. Okay. And yeah, we'll just go ahead and do that. We'll uninstall. That's weird that that's taking so long. Why is this so slow? Like, we just installed it, and I'm going to uninstall it. Why is that so incredible? Whatever. Okay. That's fine. So we're going to build the firmware for our little ESP32 based device. Figure out. These might be part of it. Okay. It's a very, very big version difference. Okay. We have space. But okay, whatever. Okay. Alexa, turn on Holden speakers. Let's go ahead and put on some nice, chill, royalty-free music. Why is Mr. Computer Box having such a hard day today? Hmm. test my speed. Speed test. Like, because these clones are taking a very long time. Okay, I guess.
Well, he was.
It's an interesting question. In fact, is. How are we getting to that? Okay. No. Trace route. I'm gonna say that's the one. Okay. So. Interesting. Why is upload coming in at 1 gig and download at 4? That's kind of weird, but whatever. Okay. Okay. Cool. Wait, do I think that's running yet? Because I rebooted this computer not too long ago. Okay. Device firmware. Virtual env. Okay, and it's the thing that's failing is MicroPython unit tests library. Okay. Take a look over here. Okay. So what we'll do here. Additional Unix libs for Unix port if not already installed. Okay. Doot. Much faster. Okay, there we go. Oh, I guess let's make a commit here too. Fix installing libs for Unix port. Cool. Okay. And then it fails. For the first one that failed. Test fake init waits. I'm gonna hope that's in the firmware directory. Okay, it's in the smoke test. Firmware smoke test. Okay. So initializing UART. Error reading line during modem boot. Singleton generator object isn't iterable. What? Okay. This feels like this is maybe something in a new version of MicroPython. Let's see if we had MicroPython pegged to a specific version. My guess is no, based on the fact that, as far as I know, this used to work. No, okay, V191. Hmm. I should have brought my laptop upstairs, because I'm, like, not convinced that I don't have unstaged local commits. On that. MicroPython. Let's see what the latest release is. Oh, 119.1. Okay, that is the same latest release. Okay, I will be right back. I am going to go and grab my laptop, which may or may not have changes that I didn't push to GitHub. No. Okay, we're back. Let's take a look and see. In the meantime, though, singleton generator object is not iterable. Okay. Oh, fuck, that's not. Whatever. Okay. Well, I guess, where do we try and use it. Waiting to get a message from Odom. That's the side of satellite. So this goes ahead. Readline self.lines.pop lines is equal to none. So that might be MicroPython. There we go. No, that's weird. Okay, that 100% worked. Checking modem net array. Waiting to get a message from modem. It would be really nice if it gave us a line number. Raw message is none. Waiting to get a message from the modem. Self S reader. Okay, what is this? S reader. Because fake UART, reader is fake UART. These are the same. And then we call readline, and then you say singleton generator object isn't iterable, making fake UART. What the fuck? Okay. Self.lines. Are we running the code I think we're running? Okay. Error reading line. During modem boot. Error reading line during modem boot. Exception E. What is the exception is blank. Like there is an exception, but it's blank. That's really weird. Okay. Stream setup. Okay. So test fake start. That works. Test fake init wait. Fails. So making a fake UART with lines, but constructing waiting to get a message from the modem, and then it prints out the current connection. Yo, Pentland debugging at its finest. Oh no, did I exit? No, I didn't. Okay, good. Wait, what? Oh, okay. What the hell? Okay. With no lines. Test fake init when it's making okay, we print okay, and then we immediately fail inside of this uasyncio wait for. I wonder if it's something happening. Uh, So I wonder, and we're gonna try this. Async def parts self return parts. I think this not iterable error is something else. This is my theory. I'm guessing, and I could be wrong, that like we just have like an old cached MicroPython libs here, so we're gonna see if this fixes it. This is looking better. Okay, yeah, so we just had an old libs directory, which is why it wasn't doing what we expected it to do. Cool. Okay. That's something to keep in mind. Okay. Let's run flash. Cool. Okay, we got the reset button down at the bottom. Minicom. That is, it's labeled as reset, but we're not seeing any reset. The other thing is this might not even be TTYACM0, and given that I just unplugged it and the device didn't go away, I'm thinking it's not TTYACM0. Okay. Reset button for good luck. Let go. Okay. No difference. Not a great sign. Showing up as a device, which is or at least not. No difference. Okay, that's not great. It could mean any number of things, actually. I have another machine. Okay, so we're gonna try this in this other machine. This also might just be a power only, not a power data. We're going to see if it shows up on this other machine. No. Okay. Open question. Then we've got this other device, the old one. Does it show up as something? It does. Fuck me. CP210X converter is now attached to PPY USB 0. Stab, TTY. Okay. So. It's not the cable. Presumably, damn it. Oh, that's annoying. Okay. So we've got, so we know we've got power. Oh, yeah, okay, so we know we've got power coming in because it turns on green, but it's also not showing up as a TTY device, but the legacy device, the big chonker one, is. So, yeah. Yeah, and the little green light's on. Okay, so let's go take a look at the design and see if we can figure out what the fuck is going on. Device. Let's go hardware. Yeah, okay, satellite hardware. Repos, hardware, V0.7. Bloop. To C3 Mini 1. Did that just break the viewer? Okay, it broke my web browser. guess, shouldn't be too surprising. Broke it again. Okay. Let's try. Okay. Wait, is every time I use the Ultium viewer just crash? Okay. I'm remembering now. I don't actually remember if I don't think I can view it with Easy EDA. I want to. So let's see if we can, but I'm doubting it's going to work, but it's worth a shot. Yeah, okay, that doesn't look like we actually succeeded at importing it the last time I tried. Okay, Ultium Viewer. Ultium Viewer does keep crashing. PC. Okay. Let's see if this works. Roll. I wish. At least chomping down on a core? Conda is. Why is Conda chomping down on a core? What am I doing with Conda? Oh, really? This is still just trying to update Conda? What the fudge? Okay. Well, okay. So at least we've got. Oh, yeah, no, I was going to go to. Oh, wait, no. It's going to fly lambs. And we're going to go to the device. No, hardware. Satellite hardware. No. There's like a nice. Okay. Let's load this with KiCad. at least try. Fuzzy memories. It does not like work super great, but I guess it's better than nothing, right? Which is where we're vibing right now. A rough time, and by having a rough time I mean Chrome seems to keep crashing, but like not all of Chrome, just like some of Chrome. I don't get this. I'm having fuzzy memories of why this kept happening. I don't remember what the solution was. I think it might be a what else could we do? Okay, well, so the other question is it just this? Okay, I'm gonna go grab one more device. Actually, yeah. We're gonna reboot. I'm gonna go grab a device, and I will be right back. Booting. Okay, so we're rebooting. It's going to take a hot minute. Another possible theory is oh. think so. Not a party. Let's see if Chrome is any less crashy. My guess is no, but a girl can dream. That's funky. Whatever, if Chrome's gonna keep crashing, let's try and move. And that's also a no. What's going on with my stuff? Okay. To Wayland versus X. I'm going to use X windows. We already have Wayland enabled as a true false. Okay, so in theory we're using X windows. Does that sound right? I don't know. Let's go union minus A. NVIDIA. Let's reinstall the NVIDIA drivers. Why not? Five one five, but there's 525. Huh. Like. let's try it, because I don't know why it's being so annoying. But okay, so the main thing that we know now is that, right, our initial test device, not super happy. We got this other test device, we're going to see, well, initial test device works. Latest test device does not. Let's see if this test device works. That's a different LED pattern. Okay, this version of the test device, which is also marked V0.7, comes up just fine. Okay, let's try. Maybe we've got too much load with the modem on it for it to run off of just USB power. It needs the battery. So let's try taking the modem out. Which would, of course, be... inconvenient, but not impossible. Okay. So let's see, because, right, so when we do it with this version, we've got both LEDs, and that power switch doesn't change anything. Okay. Let's see. So here, we got charge full power. We got charge full LED. But we don't get the charge or power LEDs lighting up, which is interesting. Oh, damn it. I hate computers. So this one works. This one does not. And these are otherwise ostensibly the same. Fuck me. Damn it. We've got the UART pins relatively easily accessible. Let's go grab a multimeter. I'm curious. I want to check some things. I will be right back again. Okay. I'm gonna go to talking mode. Cool. So we're going to do some conductivity tests. I'm just noticing the soldering here on the USB connector is different between the two boards. And I'm wondering if that is the cause of or related to any issues. Let's see here. Okay, so first things first, we're going to take our good board, the board that we know that works, which is this one, and we're gonna do some like just kind of like initial poking around. Should not be connected. That should be connected. So I would think. Okay. So right now we're just sort of checking some basic ground stuff. Okay. So that's good. So. Yeah. If we had an Altium, you know what, actually, yeah, I'm gonna, on this other computer where I do have Altium viewer working, I'm going to bring that up, and then I can figure out where or which traces should go where, and so we can try and figure out where the USB, assuming it's the USB connection that's worked, not the power. Could be the power. Oh, actually, yeah. So when we plug this in, what is it that lights up? So we've got charge full and power light up. So okay, so we've got a whole bunch of different shit. Okay, well, over. Okay. So. Question. So, okay, the charge full. Oh, right, yeah, I was gonna. Damn it, sorry. Hardware? Yeah, hardware. This is taking some time. Okay. So. My guess, though, is. Okay. Let's go up the screen. Oh, those are all just ground, I think. Okay, so maybe that shouldn't matter so much if it's. But none of these have solder in them. Like, if we look. We look here, we like didn't fill. I can't. They didn't put any solder in these little holes. And I guess it's not showing up super clearly. But I can't help but wonder if. There we go. But it's underneath the connector. Oh no, it's not quite underneath the connector. Okay. Is it? So it's. Okay. Well, let's focus on the good one, as it were. Okay, well, I mean, we know that there's missing solder, and I'm not entirely sure what's going on, but I think the key is, or like, so if we look here, you can see, and then here, those holes are filled with solder. So my guess is, and this is admittedly like a guess, that they just didn't do a very good job soldering the board, and that's why one version of it works and the other version of it doesn't work. And like, that's obviously, you know, frustrating, but so okay, I think this is at the point where I'm probably going to kick it over. So yeah, I think this is a reach the point where it's not software. We have a pretty good guess that it's not software. We have a pretty good guess that it's not the design, based on the fact that the version made by another company with the same design files works, and it's most likely the manufacturing. That's my guess based on that information and the fact that the soldering looks pretty heckin' different on the USB connector. Now, to be clear, you know, I'm not a hardware engineer. I do software, and then hardware is sort of like, So maybe that is fine, and I'm just misdiagnosing it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to reach out to a friend who does more hardware stuff, and I'm going to send him a picture of these two boards side by side, and we'll go from there. And most likely, I'll end up contacting the manufacturer if my friend says I'm not crazy, which I would like to be the case. If my friend says that my like guess seems accurate, then I'll reach out to the manufacturer and we'll try and figure out why they didn't put solder where I'm pretty sure they're supposed to, because the other manufacturer did. And we'll go from there. I'm glad we only got two made. Although we got it made with the people that we want to get it made in bulk with eventually, and this is just because they can get access to parts that other people seem to be having difficulty with. On the flip side, they seem to be having difficulty making things, so that's a little bit annoying. But we will go from there, and but I like all of this is like seems to, because like once again, like I'm not an expert here. So it could be like something that I fucked up, and it might not be JLC PCB's fault, or PCB Way, or whoever the fuck. My memory is so. Is it? Who's the Easy EDA people? I feel like Easy EDA is JLC PCB. Yeah. Okay. I mean, worst case scenario, We can go somewhere else, and we'll just deal with the lead times on the components sucking. But I'd really like to get it made with them, because we already have some parts there. Although I could just have those parts made for the other device that I've got, which is the motorcycle light device, and that would probably be fine. Okay, so we're going to wrap, and yeah, thanks for joining. Krishna, sorry I didn't have an answer for your question, but yeah, not thinking so much about Spark right now today. Cool. Have a good day, y'all.
Bye.
Oh, wait, no camera here. Bye.